Guys, good morning. Now my hair was up in some type of ball. I don't know how I did it, like this or something. I took it down because it was looking crazy. I'm gonna have to retwist my hair. I have the event on Saturday, guys, the women's event that I'm hosting, so I'm gonna have to retwist it anyway, but I'm just not doing it right now. I've been kind of busy, guys. I'll probably do it on Friday afternoon. It's Friday morning. I'm gonna have to go get the stuff for it, and Saturday I'm gonna have to go get some stuff for it too. But anyways, guys, I dropped the kids to school this morning. I feel good. Spent my devotional time, prayed, sent out the word, was able to, just spend a few, moments in God's presence before coming on doing this video, and also before leaving the house. And I stopped and got a burrito from Taco Bell. It's like $1.50. I get them sometimes. They're kind of good. And I had a yogurt. Got my salad from home in the bag, so I'm probably gonna just eat that later on for lunch. But I have to go after I do these. I'm gonna take my sister. She gotta go to the doctor again. Now I'm gonna take her to her job and drop her off, and then I'll probably go to the library. I wanted to go for my walk this morning. I'm gonna see if I have time before I go get Justice from school. I may go for my walk, but I gotta get to the library. So tired yesterday. But I'm gonna get to the library and try to like maybe type for like 30 minutes or an hour towards the book. So let me turn this down some. Even though I like this song, but I don't be knowing how loud it be until I upload it. But guys, what we're doing for this morning's video, and I did pray for you guys this morning as well, we're going to be reading from Psalm 7 and also Ezekiel 34. That's what we're reading from this morning. The Four Seasons of Marriage, guys. I'm also going to upload something for you guys for that. I'm trying to think, what else did I have though? I'm also going to upload for you guys maybe 5 to 10 minutes or so after this video, because I'm trying for us to close that book out over the next couple of days so that we can begin for like early March or so, the purpose-driven life. And we're pretty much almost done with the Four Seasons of Marriage book, so we've read a lot, we've covered a lot in a short amount of time to me. So I'm proud of that. But guys, let's read Ezekiel 34 first. It's talking about shepherds and sheep. And let's pray before we, jump into this. Lord, we ask that you bless our Bible reading today, God. I ask that you touch minds and hearts today. And God, we just give you all glory, honor, and praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. So, guys, when we did our Ezekiel series, we did read the book of Ezekiel. So, we did read this before a couple months ago, sometime late last year. But this was what God put on my heart for us to read again today. So the word of the Lord, we're in Ezekiel 34 talking about shepherds and sheep. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say to them, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Woe to the shepherds of Israel who only take care of themselves. Should not shepherds take care of the flock? You eat the curds, clothe yourselves with the wool, and slaughter the choice animals, but you do not take care of the flock. You have not strengthened the weak or healed the sick or bound up the injured. You have not brought back the strays or searched for the lost. You have ruled them harshly and brutally. So they were scattered because there was no shepherd. Somebody say no shepherd. And when they were scattered, they became food for all the wild animals. My sheep wandered over all the mountains and on every high hill. They were scattered over the whole earth, and no one searched or looked for them. Therefore, you shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord, because my flock lacks a shepherd and so has been plundered and has become food for all the wild animals, and because my shepherds did not search for my flock but care for themselves rather than for my flock. Therefore, O shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. I am against the shepherds and will hold them accountable for my flock. I will remove them from tending the flock so that the shepherds can no longer feed themselves. I will rescue my flock from their mouths, and it will no longer be food for them. For this is what the sovereign Lord says. I myself will search for my sheep and look after them. And you know, this is going back to John 10. If we have some time this morning, I'm going to read that to you guys. This is going back a little bit to like the beginning of John 10. But look, listen to what God is saying. I myself will search for my sheep and look after them. As a shepherd looks after his scattered flock when he is with them, so will I look after my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places where they were scattered on a day of clouds and darkness. I will bring them out from the nations and gather them from the countries, and I will bring them into their own land. I will pasture them on the mountains of Israel, in the ravines, and in all the settlements in the land. I will tend them in a good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel will be their grazing land. There they will lie down in good grazing land, and there they will feed in a rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will tend my sheep and have them lie down, declares the Sovereign Lord. I will search for the lost and bring back the strays. I will bind up the injured and strengthen the weak. Glory to God. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd the flock with justice. Somebody say justice. This is a word for someone this morning. As for you, my flock, we're on Ezekiel 34:17, reading on. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. I will judge between one sheep and another, and between rams and goats. Is it not enough for you to feed on the good pasture? Must you also trample the rest of your pasture with your feet? Is it not enough for you to drink clear water? Must you also muddy the rest with your feet? Must my flock feed on what you have trampled and drink what you have muddied with your feet? Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says to them. See, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep. Because you shove with plank and shoulder, butting all the weak sheep with your horns until you have driven them away, I will save my flock, and they will no longer be plundered. I will judge between one sheep and another. I will place over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he will tend them. He will tend them and be their shepherd. I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David will be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. I will make a covenant of peace with them and rid the land of wild beasts so that they may live in the desert and sleep in the forest in safety. I will bless them in the places surrounding my hill. And then in the footnotes, A says, or I will make them in the places surrounding my hill a blessing. I will send down showers in season. There will be showers of blessing. That's time back to our foundational reading for this month, which is our Leviticus 26:4-13. That scripture that we've been standing on for the entire month of February. And that also talks about some other nuggets, but it also talks about showers of blessings and the blessing. That God will send blessing on the land, right? So let's do 27-31. The trees of the field will yield their fruit, and the ground will yield its crops. The people will be secure in their land. They will know that I'm the Lord when I break the bars of their yoke. Glory to God, and rescue them from the hands of those who enslaved them. This is a word for somebody. They will no longer be plundered by the nations, nor will wild animals devour them. They will live in safety, and no one will make them afraid. I will provide for them a land renowned for its crops, and they will no longer be victims of famine in the land or bear the scorn of the nations. Then they will know that I, the Lord, their God, am with them, and that they, the house of Israel, are my people, declares the Sovereign Lord. You, my sheep, the sheep of my pasture, are people, and I am your God, declares the Sovereign Lord. So take a moment, guys, to pause. What did you get of our Bible reading this morning, this video? Oh, this lady is walking her puppies. So what did you get out of Ezekiel 34 this morning? What was God saying to you concerning shepherds and sheep? What was he saying to you? You know, you could think about it, put them in your notes, or leave below in the comments. But let me read a little bit of John 10:10. I won't read the entire one. I just want to focus on where it's talking about. Where it's talking about the shepherd and his flock. Okay, so I'll read John 10:1-21, because the rest of John 10 is talking about the unbelief of the Jews and something else, but I'm just going to focus on the first 21 verses. So the shepherd and his flock says, I tell you the truth, the man who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of his sheep. The watchman, somebody say the watchman, opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Jesus, verse 6, reading on, Jesus used this figure of speech, or like a parable, right? But they did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus said again, I tell you the truth, I am the gate for the sheep. All whoever came before me were thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, or be kept safe. In the footnotes, he will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. You guys hear that quoted a lot. John 10:10, this is where it's coming from. Talk about the shepherd and his flock. So let's do 11 through 21. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd who owns the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, talking about the hired hand. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Because he only in it for this, right? He don't really care about the sheep, right? It doesn't say that, but I'm just saying. So then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he's a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. But Jesus is saying in 14 reading on, and we did do a John series, so I'm really not going to go deep into it. I wasn't even thinking about it, but as we read, Holy Spirit was bringing it to me to go to John 10 because it does tie a lot into what we just read in Ezekiel, right? So 14 reading on, I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. And how do you get to know a person? By a personal relationship, by going through different things with them. You get to know people by connection, by communication, right? So, I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord, his own free will, right? I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. At these words, the Jews were again divided. Many of them said, he is demon possessed and raving mad. Why listen to him? But others said, these are not the sayings of a man possessed by a demon. Can a demon open the eyes of the blind? So that's John 10, 1 through 21. And let's close with Psalm 7, guys. Oh, I need to read this too. Guys, I cannot wait to... I'm going to wait to say what I was just getting ready to say. I'll save that for a later time. Psalm 7, guys, is a Shigion in the footnotes. It says a literary or musical term of David, which he's saying to the Lord concerning Cush of Benjamite. And I know that the Lord had us read this a little while ago. So the fact that he's having us read this again is for someone. I put this pen in Psalms. See, that's what I need to have a bookmarker for me. I'm going to have to write that down on the side. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, I'm talking to myself. Psalm 7, it says, let me see. It has about 17 verses. It says, O Lord, my God, I take refuge in you. Save and deliver me from all who pursue me, or they will tear me like a lion and rip me to pieces with no one to rescue me. O Lord my God, if I have done this and there is guilt on my hands, if I have done evil to him who is at peace with me, or without cause have robbed my foe, then let my enemy pursue and overtake me. Let him trample my life to the ground and make me sleep in the dust, Selah. Arise, O Lord, in your anger. Rise up against the rage of my enemies. Awake, my God, decree justice. There go that word again. You just heard that in Ezekiel talking about justice. So God is saying for someone, he's vindicating you. He sees the situation. He sees what's going on. He's making things right. He's showing up for you. He's fighting on your behalf. He's going to take care of you. He's telling many of you, don't even worry about it. Just hold on literally to his word. Hold on to his word. Okay, so arise, O Lord, in your anger. Rise up against the rage of my enemies. Awake, my God, decree justice. Let the simple peoples gather around you. Rule over them from on high. Let the Lord judge the peoples. Judge me, O Lord, according to my righteousness, according to my integrity, O Most High. O righteous God who searches minds and hearts, bring to an end the violence of the wicked and make the righteous secure. My shield or sovereign is God Most High. My shield is God Most High who saves the upright in heart. Excuse me, guys. God is a righteous judge, a God who expresses his wrath every day. If he does not relent, he will sharpen his sword, he will bend and string his bow. And then in the footnotes, A from 11 and 12, it says, or if a man does not repent, God will sharpen his sword, he will bend and string his bow. He has prepared his deadly weapons. I wonder why would that bus park like that? Let me just show y'all what I'm talking about. Can y'all see? The bus is going the wrong way. Because they're supposed to be, this is the way to come up. See, let me just show y'all so y'all can see what I'm talking about. See how they park? And then the McDonald's people on that side is going through drive-thru. And then this morning when I was taking Justice to school, I had to get him out, and then I had to get my niece out because she had to walk in with me because, you know, you can't leave him in the car. Well, of course, you better not leave him in the car. But this one lady and this man, they had their family. Now, you know what car lot, because there's three parking lots. I go to the second parking lot. I used to go to the first parking lot. I'm going to finish reading. I used to go to the first parking lot, but it'd be so much traffic. It may take you like 10 minutes to get out of there. So I just go to the second parking lot, which I have to walk a little over, but it's easier to get out. So I've been going there for like the last maybe month or a couple weeks. This one lady and this man, for car lot, you're supposed to keep on going if you're dropping off your kids. You can go keep on going dropping off your kids for those people in elementary school, middle school, whatever, or whatever. And then if you're going to park and you're going to the Head Start building, you have to drive and park. These people stood in front of me for like 4 to 5 minutes, saw me blowing behind them. Thank God I didn't get out of the car. I'm a lot better. I was just blowing. And then they're looking crazy and taking their time. One lady, I don't know if she worked there or what. And then they deliberately were looking at me taking their time because she kept looking and he kept looking. And then he started driving slow, so I blew. And then he was acting like he was driving slow, so I drove up on side of him. Then he wanted to speed up because I guess he thought that I was going to play a game with him. So when I drove up on side of him, like, okay, if you don't go up, then he wants to drive up and keep going. And I'm like, these people with the driving. And so when I see stuff like that, and I did have to pray for them because I felt like that was very disrespectful. Then the principal, I know the principal, like she speak to me and I speak to her. She's really nice. Even she saw them do that. And then the police be there. So the police saw, but they couldn't really see, like they were stopping all that traffic behind me. And then people was behind me blowing like, what am I doing? But it's not me. They literally just stopped. So it's like if you're going to your house and somebody is parked slanted in your driveway. And if they're going to go there, they need to park. They could have easily just parked on the side or parked in the parking lot and got out and did all of that. It was very inconsiderate. So when I see stuff like that, it kind of irked my nerves because it's like, that's so disrespectful. And I know some people are like, well, some people are going to do that. I know that. I've been driving for quite some time. Trust me, I've seen some buttholes and some jerks. You know, I've seen some, but it's just when people deliberately do it, it's wrong. Like this bus, why would you just park like that and people are coming? What if someone wants to come and park over here? They can't even park because they can't even park correctly. Or what if these people from Taco Bell wants to go out? They can't even come out correctly because you could have parked. What you could have did, you could have took this big bus, drove that way correctly, and you could have parked the right way. But instead, they're parking in the middle of where people have to come. And so it's just like, that's crazy to me. That's like one of my pet peeves is that. Another one is just blatant disrespect. I be having to remember that I'm a new person in Christ now. Lord Jesus, he still be working on me with that. But guys, just little things like that, it's like, come on, you got a big bus. I don't know, but let's hurry up and close, guys. I don't even know where that came from. I guess because it's just been sitting there. It's just sitting there. All right, 12, if he does not relent, he will sharpen his sword, he will bend and strain his bow. And then some people really on the road is really crazy. So I try to be patient with some people because you don't know a person's mind. Like the road rage stories, and I've gotten a lot better with that, I'm gonna be honest. You know, and then some people like with my concealed, well, I haven't gotten it yet, but I want to get my concealed weapon license. I've been wanting to get it for a couple years. Not because of that. I want to get one. I've been supposed to have one, but I never got one. That's not something that I'm going to have that put up. Now, no one take nothing out of context. I'm not saying nothing crazy, but I'm just saying the world that we live in, some people's mind is not there. So I'm getting better. God be teaching me patience. Like as I'm driving, he be teaching me patience and long suffering with some people. You know, people that cut you off, and you know, and there's been a lot of people that cut me off. A lot of people don't put on their turning signal. Teaching me patience and grace. And then I'm telling you, I'll see as they cut me off, 2 and 3 cars, literally within 5 to 10 seconds, be done cut them off. You know, so it's like he'd be like, don't worry about it. These are people. You know, so I'm not saying I'm a great driver, but I try to be respectful of when I'm driving with other people. It's just respect, because people are already going through a lot, dealing with a lot. You doing that to a person, you never know what that person have going on. So why be inconsiderate and just a complete jerk if you don't have to? Now, some people just live to be buttholes. You know what I mean? They just live to do that. It's not like they're having a bad day. This is how they think. This is their mindset. So it's like, that's crazy. But I don't know. But I know some of you be like, you know, I do keep it calm, you know, because I know some people, because you don't know what that person have. The person don't know what you have. You don't know. So you got to be mindful of that. And then 9 out of 10, you're never going to see this car again in your life. You're never going to see them again. It's not like you're going to see them again. Now, there'll be some people that I do see again, because we all take the same route. I don't know these people. These people don't know me. But, you know, I don't know. I guess that was a morning rant. I'm so sorry. I'm going to have to put in here morning rant. That wasn't my intention. It wasn't my intention at all. But just seeing that bus like that, and just the traffic in the morning and in the afternoon be so crazy, guys. Especially these avenues that I be having to take. But I don't know. But anyway, that's my little morning rant. I'm human, y'all. Please bear with me. I mean no disrespect to nobody. Look, if he does not relent, he will sharpen his sword. Lord, have mercy on me. He will bend and screen his bow. He has, and God, thank you, Lord, for having mercy on me, because God be in here with me. He be seeing what's going on with these people. So he has prepared his deadly weapons. He makes ready his flaming arrows. He who is pregnant with evil and conceives trouble gives birth to disillusionment. He who digs a hole and scoops it out falls into the pit he has made. The trouble he causes recoils on himself. His violence comes down on his own head. I will give thanks to the Lord because of his righteousness, and will sing praise to the name of the Lord Most High. So hopefully you guys was blessed by today's video. I'm going to record a few minutes for the 4 Seasons of Marriage, and then I'm going to actually get back on the road. I love you guys. Have a great day.